What's happening, everybody? It's Chris with Lone Wolf DIY. Let me share with you today what I've got going on. I tore out this wall over here because I want to do some new wire organization. I want to look lots cleaner. I don't want to see any of that shit all over the wall, you know? So since I'm putting in all this pain in the ass work into the tiny house, I figured before I go through all the trouble of the repairs and everything, that it might be a good idea to look into upgrading the cables before I get that far along. So right here, we have our Cat 5 cable. It's not your regular Cat 5, that's a dead format. This is a Cat 5E. This is the new standard of Cat 5 cables. And this is gonna be our Cat 6. Right away, you can tell the thickness of the wire on both of these is much different. So the larger the wire, the more data that's being transferred and increasing your bandwidth. If I ever end up doing some sort of like gaming streaming here, that upload speed is what's really important, and your bandwidth and these Cat 6 cables are gonna help you with that. And also with live streaming, so like Netflix or like a sporting event. And I can't tell you how frustrating it is when you're trying to watch something like a baseball game and they're throwing pitches and at the last second it lags and you don't know what the call was or anything. Next thing you know, the dude's walking to the dugout and you're like, what the fuck? One thing that the Cat 6 cable has that the Cat 5s do not is this little splitter that runs between all the little tiny wires that keeps them separated. That helps with the electromagnetic interference, or what you would call crosstalk, and it's really gonna help to maximize your bandwidth. It looks like screening spline. That's probably what it was. He's like, look at this dude's good idea. So I'm gonna get started on cleaning up that mess over there, but it's all gonna be worth it because I cannot wait to do some gaming in this place and just be sad that I don't have an excuse as to why I keep dying because of the lag. I'm not gonna have as bad of lag because I'm gonna have so much more data to just get frustrated with and choke myself to death because these 12-year-olds are too damn good at this game because they have too much time in their hands. So since we were using the master bedroom closet as our networking closet, it didn't leave any room for shoes or clothes. So I switched up the building bridge to come into here with all my routers and everything, and then just run a nice clean AP over there. Just one little disc up there on the ceiling, and that's it. I'm having a lot of fun legitimately doing this. And in the end, this tiny house is gonna be super badass. I'll be able to rent this place out and just tell people like it's got the sickest network in there, man. Throw parties out here, it'd be super badass. I would say badass, I don't know, cause I wanna say like and like I can't say the like you can't just say that's rad, dude. Like you gotta say it's like I feel censored. It's hard to be punk rock and care at the same time. It's gonna be so awesome for watching movies and stuff, man. I cannot wait. Wait till you see when I finish this thing up, man. It's gonna be, well, I hope you're as blown away as I blew myself away.
I feel like I've done this before.
It's all dirty, man. Black is so hard to keep clean. It looks so nice without wires all over the place. I finally got this pain in the ass tiny house done, but dude, it looks so cool. Check this out.
Welcome, douchebag.
So I just love how it turned out in here. I love the black color, and when I'm playing games or I'm streaming movies, I don't like to have my eye distracted by bright lights or something flickering on a VCR or something like that. And as cool as the star display is on the UDM, I also hit that. And it's all behind this wall right here that I like to call the black box. In the black box, there's quite a bit of stuff going on in here. I've got all my access gear. I've got my router, my UDM Pro, and my Switch, and I also have my PlayStation in there, and all those wires are all nice and hidden, and I just love how there's nothing here to distract your eye. At nighttime, the only thing that's on is the TV, so when you're sitting here, just really nice focal point. That's what I like. And then I hung up these guitars over here that I wish I knew how to play. And then I got this cool thing for my birthday. And what this is it's kind of like Peloton for boxing. And you can take classes and stuff on a TV, and I needed some space, and the tiny house is great for that. And luckily, now that I got my building-to-building bridge from Ubiquity, I've got enough broadband and Wi-Fi signal in the tiny house to do that. And then over here, check that out, man. This is my projector, and I've got the projector up on top. Last night we were playing the Suns game on here, which they kicked the Nuggets' ass, by the way. And we had all the lights out, and it was so nice. And then I've got these LED displays that were like making the wall glow. And what was really cool was it didn't affect the picture at all. The picture was nice and clean, and then you had this really cool glow all the way around. And you can change the colors. I find the red is the easiest on the eye, but you can do blues and whatever color you can think of. And I also put LEDs around the door here, so it's kind of like an exit in the movie theater. You know where you're going. So when it's like pitch black over here, I can hit the remote and have these lights glow around the door. It looks super cool. So that's it. That's the tour. It's a pretty tiny house. There's not much to see except my cool original movie posters. And even though they're original, when this guy sent it, it was all crinkled up piece of shit. And then my dog got a hold of this one and tore a little nice spot over there, which I spray painted in so you can't really tell. And then this is my cozy futon couch that's designed for children. So thanks everybody for checking out the tiny house. It was an awful lot of fun doing this, and I can't wait to do more projects. So make sure to come back and see me. Hit that like button, hit the subscribe, please, and that little notification thing. It really helps me out, and I would love to see you come back. So thanks again for watching, and have a nice day. It's so in here, I can't even anymore. But this is gonna be for moving. I cannot wait.